Guys, I'm Kevin Hart, and I want to welcome you to season 9 of Cold as Balls. The show's getting bigger and better. Why? Well, because we're the same. Nothing's different. And Edgar, take your robe off, put it on the hooks. This is gonna be cool.
Where do I keep my title?
Put it on your shoulder or your waist.
All right. Ice boys won't take it, right?
No, ain't nobody gonna take it. Come on, man. I can't believe this.
Oh,
every
man.
Time I think it can't get bigger, then boom, boom.
Wow.
Yeah. All right, Ray, this is what we do, man. We sit on the back of the tub.
Okay.
Get in there.
Are you good, all right? You feel all right?
Yeah, I'm good. Come on, man. Sit on the back of the tub. Welcome, world. I'm, of course, your host, the Kevin Hart. And today, well, we got a legend on the show, Mr. Rey Mysterio. Yes. Hi, come on. Come on, guy.
Iceman. Hold on. Wait a minute. What? These ain't the right ones.
Huh?
No, no, come on. I've seen this show before. That's not them.
No, those are my guys. All right.
Can I ask you, Kev, where you got that mask?
MaskRUs.com, something like that.
You know I ain't making royalties off of that, right?
Huh.
Take off the mask.
Hmm?
Bullshit. Come on, take off the mask. That's not you.
Here we go. Three.
That ain't you.
Two.
Take off the mask.
One. All right. There it is.
Ah! I knew it.
Knew what?
Iceman.
No.
Take off the mask.
No.
Ah, come on. Mask off. I knew it.
Damn it.
Kev! Get the f*** out here. Come on. Where you at?
I'm coming. Get off the set. Fake Bam and fake Daryl. Get your ass out of here. Boy, you got some nerve.
Man.
I told you, match your movements to my mouth. That's what I said to you. Hey, Ray.
Yeah, come on, Ray. That's the Kev I was.
Yeah, man. Man, this is probably one of my favorite guests right here.
Now, I gotta say something.
What's that, sir?
I want to get this right off my chest right away. I'm surprised. I actually thought that you were going to be taller than me.
Well, I am, right?
What do you mean?
I'm clearly towering.
That hat is...
I'm towering over you. Towering.
Are you sure about that?
Not too often I get to do that. Come on, Ray, sit down, man. Get on the back of the tub. You and I, we got beef. I said, when I talk, you do the movements, right? I said that. I said, every time I talk, do the mannerisms that I would do, and ain't nobody gonna know nothing. But what do? You wanna go rogue, and you was doing too much of this. God damn. Go ahead, man. What? Now listen, you listen to me, and you listen good. You, well, I'm about a nickel off of your ass, and I ain't got change. Get out of here, man. Go on. And who the fuck are these guys? Where's Bam and Daryl? Hey, man, take off your mask. Man, if you don't get your goddamn R&B face up out of here and go goddamn make an album, try to pull one over on me. You, who the hell? Take off your mask. What the fuck is going on? Get your old ass out of here. Now! Now! Because I'm hurt don't mean everybody else is. Now that's Daryl. And that's Bam. That's right. Listen, world, unfortunately, I can't get in the tub. Why? I broke my
Well, how'd you do that?
Sprinting. I tried to run a 40-yard dash against an NFL player. Felt like in the middle of the race, my flew off, Ray.
Holy crap.
I am 44 years old, man.
I just ran a 40 three days ago.
Mm-hmm.
I'm 49. And I won this 2 weeks ago.
Holy shit. What are you doing on a day-to-day to help you stay in that type of condition?
Part of my therapy every morning is the cold plunge.
So you should have no problem with getting your ass in this one. Get in there. Get in there, right there. Yeah. 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 Now, Ray, we got to start at the beginning.
Oh.
Ray, where you from?
Born in San Diego.
Big family? Small family?
Big family. Youngest out of four.
Holy shit, that's where the wrestling came from.
Actually, the wrestling came from my uncle.
Okay.
Who started wrestling in Tijuana.
Did your uncle take you under his wing?
So because my uncle had no children at that time, he saw me as his adopted child.
How soon did you realize I think that I got what it takes to be one of the biggest and best to do this.
So I knew by the sixth grade that this is what I wanted to do. By then, I had already been in the ring. I had grown up watching my uncle wrestle every Friday night in Tijuana, and I became so passionate and obsessed with wrestling.
A big question for me is, how did you overcome doubt in your career?
My biggest fear was not being able to be given the opportunity.
Wear the right size pants.
What was that?
It wasn't finding your size?
Yeah, it was my size.
What are you gonna say?
No, just my build. You know, people thought I was too small.
Yeah.
Muy pequeño.
Muy pequeño.
Yeah.
Too hot.
Yes.
That's too hot, that muy pequeño.
Muy caliente.
Muy caliente is good.
Sí.
Muy caliente es huevo.
Do I have to stay here all the time?
Yes, man, we're talking.
I'm gonna tough it out.
All right, tough it out for me.
Yeah.
Tell you how I overcome my doubt. I use Swagger body wash from Old Spice. Give me the goddamn thing. Old Spice Swagger body wash, 24/7 shower fresh with daily use. White hand, thank you. So, what do you think was the captivating component that made the people go, okay, now that guy is somebody special?
Well, I was doing moves back then that I was creating in my mind.
They say the hardest part about creating a move is giving it a name. Mm-hmm. Were you a good move namer?
I suck.
Yeah, I'm not a good move namer either. Like, I used to do one move. It was a peanut butter nugget. That was when a guy came in and I would tap him on the shoulder and he would turn around and look the other way and I would pull out peanut butter, right, from my pocket. And I would put peanut butter on my hand and then he would turn around and I would go, nugget.
Slap him with it?
Just slap him with peanut butter. And he'd be like, oh, what is it? Because he never would have seen the can. So technically, he would have thought it was shit. Right now, I mean, you're talking about being a vet. There's not many people that can come in and step in your territory.
No. I mean, I made the mistake of leading my son into this.
He's doing well.
You got a son too, right?
Yes, my son is 15, about to be 16.
Okay.
Taller than me.
My son's taller than me too, but yeah. I still whoop his.
Are they our kids?
I don't know.
I'm gonna do a swab.
Oh, I already did.
I think my son like 5'8".
My kid is 6'2".
6'2"! You introduce him to the business.
Yeah.
He's flourishing in the business. Like, he's doing well. What do you mean? What is that?
Turned his back on his dad. Come on.
There is no great story without the story of downfall. Your son chose the right opportunity for a great rivalry. Does he say shit to you, like, around the house when you guys are out? Like,
he doesn't do it now because I kicked him out the house.
So it's real.
Oh, it's real.
It's real.
He's out.
Get your ass out of
here. He's 26 years old.
Yeah.
Get your own place.
Figure it out.
Yeah.
Son.
Yeah.
That might not be mine.
Exactly.
Yeah. Is his involvement in the sport strictly off of watching my dad do what he did?
It's gotta be.
That's huge.
As like me seeing my uncle. His growth has been incredible over the past 3 years. So I faced him for the very first time at WrestleMania this past year.
To be able to wrestle against your son.
Oh my God, incredible. Best feeling in the world.
The best feeling in the world.
I've worked.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Where did the mask come from? Why the mask?
My uncle, when he started wrestling, he wanted to hide it from his family, from his mom and dad. And he decided to wear a mask. His first actual match was on El Día de los Reyes Magos.
That's sí.
Caliente.
¿Cómo te llamas?
Rey Mysterio.
Ah,
yeah.
Coy, me llamo.
¿Cómo? Sí. A huevo.
¿Dónde quisiera? Yeah. So when your uncle had the mask on, did people not know it was him for real?
They didn't know.
Were these people stupid?
No. You have two lives.
Did his mask look like yours?
Very similar.
I clearly can see Rey. I'm not like, who's Rey?
Should I take off my mask then?
No, don't take off your mask, because that's going to mess up the mystique.
Okay.
What do you... Tell me why. Just tell me why. Why do we... We're having a very intimate conversation, and then you guys go and do something stupid like that. What is that? Looks like the Power Ranger mask or something. Right now, you're 49 years old, right? What are you thinking about for after?
Man, that's a good question. I think more than anything is to give some time back to my wife who has put her career on the line and her time to raise two kids, you know, to support me, you know, to let me pursue my dream.
Mm-hmm.
The rest of my lifetime, I just want to be able to enjoy it and share it with her.
How long have you been married?
27 years.
27 years?
What's wrong?
Shit, man.
What happened?
The same face in every morning.
I wake up happy every morning.
I mean, do you?
Yeah.
We just cracked 7 years married. I don't know what I'm thinking, 27 years. Jesus Christ. I caught her looking at me the other day, and I think there was a thought of like, look at this old motherfucker here. Because I'm on crutches and I got a wheelchair around the house and I can't really wash my ass, so I need help with my stuff. And that's where it's falling apart for me in the house. Ray, there was a Mount Rushmore of wrestlers. Give me your Mount Rushmore.
Ric Flair.
Woo! Hey, that's enough! Don't put them on. Bam. Hey, wait, where's my butt? KP2! Come on, get in the tub. I need this shot so I can edit it. Come on, get in the tub, man. Give me a second, Ray. I'm just doing this for post. Take the goddamn mask off. You want to do everything but what I tell you. Come on, get in the goddamn tub, man. All the way. Sit in the goddamn tub. All right, Bam, put some ice in here. When he puts the ice in there, you give it a good shake, okay? I'll give you the verbal, just match my words. Guys, I want these close-ups so we can take my face and put it over here, okay? So this has to look like I'm in a tub. This is for the edit. Wait, does that look like I'm having an orgasm or does that look like I'm freezing? No more, Bam. Please, please. No. Okay, that's enough. Whoo. Oh, this shit cold, Ray. This shit cold, like an igloo. Okay, so we were talking about your Mount Rushmore. Ray, you said Ric Flair.
Hulk Hogan's gotta be on there.
Hulk Hogan.
Yeah.
Wow. And I don't think there's a better person. What the fuck is going on? Y'all jumping me? Y'all jumping me? I'm honored that you came on our show. We have really embraced the wrestling world more. The sport has been big. The sport loves you. The sport needs you. Ladies and gentlemen, does it get better? Does it get bigger? God, do my hands. Are you doing the shit that I do? How am I using it in the edit if you don't do what I do? Let's end it on another bang. Go ahead, Daryl. Hit him. Hit him, Daryl. Yeah, hit him. Oh, down is my legs. Oh, shit, man. Hey, man, as we go, we gotta figure this shit out. Okay, so we're gonna get in the back, and we're gonna have a meeting, okay? Because this is getting scary, okay? Mm-hmm. All right, Ray. Man, what a time. So I broke my, what you doing? Give it to me so I can get on. I said, give it to me so I can get on out of here now. What are you doing? You can walk, jackass. Thank you, Ray. Yeah, see that? I didn't even think about that.
Yeah, huh? I got you.
Boy, you know how to do it. Yeah, this ain't a guy. Look into the future.
Yes.